For residents living near the coast at Barangay Sabang in Surigao City, a sheet of plastic canvas goes a long way to surviving the rainy season in this typhoon-hit region. The wide sheets are among the relief supplies many brought home from an international NGO, along with drinking water containers and hygiene kits. But many are waiting to receive the cash aid of up to 5,000 pesos from the national government promised by President Duterte. They say they plan to buy construction materials with the money.
Bibili ko po ng ano, bubong po, kasi bubong po talaga yung kailangan ko po, sir. Meron naman din akong mga, meron pa naman ako mga poste pang ano sa bahay ko. Basta importante lang po talaga yung bubong.
Kagabi, basang-basa kami, maginaw. At ako'y nagtanggap lang ng sahod na 200 pesos per day. So paano ko yun na ano, dahil may sakit ako. Parang shoot talaga.
The nearly 5 billion peso aid for 6 typhoon-hit regions will be sent to local government units by the budget department beginning Wednesday. But in Surigao del Norte, typhoon survivors have yet to receive the money.
Pinapalpalo up namin ngayon na hopefully baka by tomorrow makapunta na yung mga magdala ng pera para naman maibigay sa mga affected individuals na dahil sa Typhoon Odette.
Governor Matugas adds, residents who lost their homes can expect an additional 5,000 peso aid from the National Housing Authority, which approved 80 million pesos in funds for the province.
Temporarily, what we are doing is we will be providing construction materials, tarpaulin, corrugated zinc, plywood, and ganon. So we are asking donations from private companies and individuals to help us establish this mga construction materials. Kasi yung kailangan ngayon eh, lalo na ngayon in Surigao del Norte, it's a rainy season.
With electricity still out in most of the province, Surigao residents who still have their homes are finding ways to power up their gadgets and produce light, especially at night. Two regional electric cooperatives are working all day to restore power in Surigao City, but hundreds continue to fill the free charging stations beside City Hall, whether for flashlights or laptops. Local vendors who also lost their stores to the typhoon are cashing in by selling rechargeable or solar-powered gadgets near the city center, with emergency lights among their more popular wares. Some of the customers came all the way from Surigao Island.
Sana madali yung pagbalik ng ano, pag-restore ng ano, kuryente. Kasi ano, napakahirap talaga doon sa amin kasi. Parang hindi mo alam kung saan ka mag-umpisa, kung saan ka mag, hindi mo alam talaga. Lalo na paggabi, parang natatakot na yung mga bata.
Meanwhile, the Provincial Health Board is set to convene and call on the Philippine Department of Health to declare a public health emergency on Surigao Island following a diarrhea outbreak. 231 residents have already been listed ill, while 8, most from the town of Geneva Luna, have died from severe dehydration due to lack of potable water. Anjo Bagawisan, ABS-CBN News, Surigao City.